Today on RUTV, Popcorn makes its final appearance.
Then, Luca wraps up current events.
Finally, Kat shines the spotlight on our student athletes one last time.
Kick back and relax, everyone, because it all starts right now on RUTV.
Good morning, Seahawks. Today is Friday, May 17th. I'm Shella Reese.
And I'm Kat Wong. Today is one of our last broadcasts. Can you believe that, Charlotte?
Not at all. I feel like the year just started. I've loved all the segments we've had this year.
I know, especially Pop Corner and Current Events. Those were big hits.
Mm-hmm. Remember when the anchors dressed up as each other for April Fools?
Oh my gosh, I forgot about that. That was so funny. I'm definitely going to miss staying up to date with all of pop culture.
Me as well. But before the year ends, here's Kendall with Pop Corner.
Hey Seahawks, I'm Kendall, and welcome to the last installment of Pop Corner for the 2023 to 2024 school year. We've had a great time keeping you up to date about what's happening in the world of entertainment, from the removal of UMG's licensed music from TikTok, to most recently discussing everything that happened at this year's Met Gala. Well, almost everything, that is. In the last week, internet users have been up in arms in response to influencer and model Hailey Khalil's Met Gala post, in which she was lip-syncing the line, "Let them eat cake," with a group of onlookers behind her, and a barricade separating the heavily made-up Khalil from her casually dressed audience. Critics are calling the video insensitive and a key example of how dystopian this year's Met Gala felt in light of the political upheaval the United States is experiencing right now. What really upset TikTok users, though, was Khalil's apology video in which she tried to convince viewers that she is not a high-profile celebrity who was a guest at the Met Gala, but rather another fan of the event who was excited at the opportunity to collaborate with E! News to create some pre-Met Gala content. However, it was later revealed that Khalil's pays up to $17,000 a month in rent for her lavish New York City apartment, so she, among many other wealthy celebrities, have been blocked by various internet users, either due to their wealth or stance on the conflict between Israel and Palestine. In other controversial news, this past Saturday, Harrison Butker, the kicker for the Kansas City Chiefs, delivered a speech at Benedictine's college graduation ceremony, which has left many listeners outraged. Butker addressed the school's female graduates and briefly congratulated them before promptly telling them that, up until then, they had been told diabolical lies, and that although some of them may go on to lead successful careers in the world, he would venture to guess that the majority of them are most excited about their marriage and the children that they will bring to this world. Butker then went on to quote a lyric from Taylor Swift's Midnight's album, referring to Swift simply as his teammate's girlfriend, to promote his belief that growing support for degenerative cultural values in the media all stem from pervasiveness of disorder, and that familiarity breeds contempt, as Swift sang. Butker went on to criticize and offend more groups, including the LGBTQ+ community, calling their pride a deadly sin, and also saying that he is beyond blessed that his wife Isabel would convert to his faith, become his wife, and embrace one of the most important titles of all, homemaker. Finally, pivoting to some musical news, Eurovision, the European Song Contest, similar to American Idol, wrapped up last Tuesday, May 7th, with the artist Nemo from Switzerland winning first place. In light of this victory, many fans were upset with the disqualification of Dutch artist Joost Klein, who was eliminated after he apparently shoved the journalist who was filming him without his consent in a designated no-filming zone during the quarterfinals of the competition. This decision to disqualify Klein was met with a lot of discontent due to the fact that the assault allegations were mere rumors and later proved to be groundless, as Klein was not found to be in the wrong. Many fans of the show felt that Klein's song Europapa was set to win and that first place was essentially stolen from the artist after his removal. Well, Seahawks, what do you think? Should Europapa come out on top? Pop on over at Redondo Union TV on Instagram to let us know. This has been Pop Corner. I'm Kendall Keenan, and we'll see you next year.
Thanks so much, Kendall. I love listening to all the entertainment news, but for those of us who prefer sports, look no further. Here's Damian Olive.
Welcome back to RUTV Sports. I'm Olive Rowe.
And I'm Jamie Dynas. Boys volleyball fought their way to the CIF Southern Section Finals last week, but unfortunately fell short 0-3 to Santa Margarita. However, they did make it far enough to advance to D2 CIF State. They had their first game this past Tuesday and swept Chatsworth in three sets, scoring 28-26 in the first, 25-16 in the second, and 25-15 in the third. Sophomore Cash Essert, juniors Bobby Bennett and Drew Blair, and senior Luke Goldman all had great performances and helped move their team onto round two. Awesome job, boys.
Last Thursday, softball played in the CIF quarterfinals against Etiwanda. In a tight game, sophomore Abby Lewis went 1-for-2 at bat, along with junior Kaya Aguirre and senior Daisy Baker, who both went 1-for-3. Our girls fought hard till the end, but sadly could not secure the win and ended up losing just 3-0.
Unfortunately, this did bring them to the end of their season. But great job, girls. You should be proud of your accomplishments.
This past weekend at Moore Park High School, our track team competed in the CIF Southern Section Finals. Senior Camila Brennan vaulted 11 feet 7 inches, qualifying herself for the Masters meet this Saturday. Our 4x8 team also qualified, which means that this is potentially one of their last races of Seahawks, and hopefully they will be able to make it to state. Good luck!
Lastly, let's send it over to Kat Wong, who has another athlete spotlight.
Hey Seahawks, this is Kat Wong, your sports director. I'm here with Kiki Yokogawa at the track. This is your final athlete spotlight for the year. All right, Kiki, looking back at your track season this past year, what has been your proudest moment?
My proudest moment was going to Arcadia for three events, and it's one of the biggest high school meets in the nation. I made it in the 4x1, my single 100, and the 4x400, and it was just a really cool experience to be there.
That's super cool. Congratulations. What was your favorite event to run there?
Definitely the 4x100 because we won our heat and we got gold and we got third overall, so it was just such a cool feeling to get a medal there and just know that my team has worked so hard for that.
Well, I know that you're a very talented runner, so is there anybody that you look up to in the sense of like famous runners or anybody on your team that helps you?
I definitely look up to Shakari Richardson just because we're about the same height, and usually pro sprinters are really tall, but she's actually 5'1", and it just kind of shows that in this sport, height doesn't matter, and she's one of the best sprinters in the world, so it just kind of shows that I do have a shot to get as far as she does.
How have you overcome that battle? Because I know it's very hard as an athlete to not be up to the regular normal standard, but obviously you're very talented, so how have you kind of overcome that?
Honestly, I just remember that I've had so much training, everything I've worked for in the summer, in the winter, and just kind of leading up to every single race that I've ran in the spring, just knowing that I put in the work, and I may not get the results all the time, but I know that I put in the work every single day, day in, day out.
Speaking of putting in the work, I know track comes with a lot of training, so what is your normal like training schedule look like?
On Monday, we usually do some speed work. Tuesday, I have a really long, heavy workout that puts all of us out on the floor afterwards. And then Tuesday night, I have private training that I do. Wednesday is technical work, so blocks and handoffs and any type of running form. And I also lift after school. And then Thursday is super light, handoffs again, a little bit of block starts. And Friday is complete rest, and Saturday I compete.
Well, that's a lot of work. How do you maintain a school work athlete life balance?
I definitely have a really light senior schedule that helps with it. But honestly, any downtime I have, I'm doing my homework, I'm studying on my laptop, my phone. Have my packets or flashcards with me, and I just try to do all of my work before I go to practice since my practices do run very late and I do not get home until like 11.
Oh my gosh, that is super impressive. Shout out to all you student athletes. You guys are superheroes. I could never imagine balancing all of that work. Anyways, is there any like piece of advice you would leave behind for your underclassmen?
Don't skip practice. Don't skip a rep. I know the workouts are horrible. Believe me, I have done that for 3 years now, but it's worth it. You have to do it. You have to get in shape. You have to get the strength, and you need the training. It's going to be rough, but in the end, it works, and it will be such a worthwhile experience.
All right. Thank you so much. It's been awesome getting to watch you run as your friend and as the sports director for RUTV. For the last time, I'm Kat Wong, and I'm here with
Kiki Yokogawa.
And back to you guys in the studio.
Thank you so much, Kat. RUTV loves being able to show off our amazing student athletes.
Well, that's all for this week.
We had a great time anchoring for you all this year.
And for the last time, from all of Roe and I, go Seahawks! Seahawks!
Our athletes making it to CIF is a great way to close out our year. But don't look away from the screen just yet, because Luca has our last edition of current events.
Thanks, Charlotte. This past week, independent presidential candidate Robert F. Kennedy Jr.'s campaign detailed to the press his past issues with a parasitic worm in his brain. In a 2012 divorce deposition, Kennedy stated that his health issues may have been caused by, quote, a worm that got into my brain and ate a portion of it and then died. His campaign has said to the press that the issue was resolved years ago and that he's been extensively vetted for mental and physical fitness. In local news, beloved long-standing anchor of KTLA, Sam Rubin, has unfortunately passed away. His family has confirmed that he suffered a sudden heart attack on Friday. Rubin joined KTLA in 1991 and quickly made a lasting impact on the station with his, quote, encyclopedic knowledge of film and television. Rubin's passing has left many employees and personalities at KTLA devastated as they look back on his time at the station. In line with the legacy of his work, Rubin will be remembered as an institution of entertainment news. In national news, NASA astrophysicist Jane Rigby was awarded the Presidential Medal of Freedom on May 3rd, the highest honor a civilian can receive. She was presented the award for her contributions as senior project scientist for the James Webb Space Telescope, the most powerful telescope ever created. She is an outspoken advocate for equity and inclusion in STEM fields for women and LGBTQ individuals. Seahawks, it's been an honor being your source for reliable and accurate current news this school year. I'd like to thank you all for your trust and confidence. For the last time this school year, this is Luca Richardson reporting for Current Events.
Seniors, if you and your friends want to be featured in one of our last RUTV broadcasts of the 2023-2024 school year, scan this QR code and share some of your favorite memories from this year's senior sunrise, school rallies, and dances, as well as the senior excursion to Disney's California Adventure.
Also, remember to wear your college merch on Tuesday, May 21st for a group commitment photo. I'll know I'll be there in a Chicago State sweatshirt.
I'll be in an Arizona State one. Seniors, our favorite teacher, Mr. Shihei, is also recording senior farewells. If you couldn't get to it yesterday, make sure to stop by the Alumni House today.
Next week is also Senior Spirit Week. On Monday, dress like your elementary school self.
On Tuesday, wear college merch.
On Wednesday, wear Disney merch or dress up as your favorite Disney character.
Wear pajamas on Thursday.
And finally, wear a blank shirt for others to sign on Friday.
To former Hermosa Valley students, join the superintendent and principal of Hermosa Schools on May 22nd at lunch in the Bingo Room to share your thoughts and experiences about your time at Hermosa Valley and at Redondo Union so they can better support future Hermosa RUHS students. Free pizza will be served.
If you're passionate about mental health awareness and interested in helping on campus next year, apply to be a peer counselor at the Wellness Center. Applications are due May 31st and are found through a link in your emails.
Speaking of mental health awareness, May is Mental Health Month. Make sure to take care of yourself by resting and relaxing, especially after all those APs. The RUHS Wellness Center and NAMI Club will be hosting multiple events for Health Week next week as well.
Lastly, join RUHS Football, Flag Football, and Cheer for the annual Pancake Breakfast Fundraiser tomorrow. Tickets are $10 and can be purchased from athletes on www.ruhsfootball.net or at the door.
Well, Seahawks, that's all for this week. Thanks for being here with us. As always, I'm Kat Wong.
And I'm Charlotte Reese. Make sure you guys have a great weekend. Stay classy. And remember to
keep on soaring, Seahawks.